a poor fisherman named Sean O'Neill. Now, Sean was a very hard-working fellow, but a very quiet, shy sort, and he was no good with the girls at all, and he often wondered would he ever find a wife. Well, one day, when he was down near the rocks on the other side of the pier in Liscannor, didn't he lay eyes on the most beautiful girl he had ever seen. 'Twas love at first sight. And as Sean got closer to her, he realized that 'twas a Selkie he was looking at, because he saw her taking off her copping dreata, her magic cap, her skin itself, and rolling it up in a ball, and he saw her put it under the rock. And Sean knew that if he could lay his hands on that copping dreata, the Selkie would belong to him. So he crept up quietly behind her, and just as he picked up the copping dreata, the Selkie looked up in terror. But Sean told her not to worry, that he had fallen in love with her. And when she saw the love in his eyes, she believed him. And he asked her to go home with him and to be his wife. And she agreed, and she was welcomed into the community. And she and Sean became husband and wife and lived many happy years together. And they had three beautiful children, and they might have lived happily ever after. But one day, Sean told his wife that he was going to the market in Ennis, and she decided to use the time to give the house a good cleaning from top to bottom. And she even went up into the rafters. And 'twas while she was up in the rafters that she found her copping dreata. And when she held that magic cap close to her, a great longing came over her to return to her family in the land under the waves. But how can I leave my family here, she thought. Oh, I'll just go for a visit, she said. And she gave the children a hug and a kiss. And she told the eldest girl to mind the baby. And then she took her copping dreata and she ran down to the sea. And when Sean came home that day, his eldest daughter told him what had happened. And he ran down to the waves, but there was no sign of his beautiful wife, and he never saw her again. But he and everybody in County Clare believed that she would have come back to them, but her father was probably Manannan MacLir himself, the lord of the land under the waves, and he had kept her down there and wouldn't allow her to return. But ever after that, from that day to this, she is remembered as the most loving of wives and devoted of mothers.